The U.S. Air Force awarded Kratos and General Atomics contracts worth a combined $20 million for further development of the autonomous Skyborg drone Wingman. That's according to a Monday announcement from the service. Kratos received $13.2 million to continue work on its XQ-58A, while General Atomics got $7 million for its MQ-20 Avenger. The funding will allow the companies to continue integrating their air vehicles with the Leidos-built autonomous core system, which acts as the Skyborg's brain. It also pays for continued flight testing and experimentation, which will inform the Air Force whether the Skyborg drone is ready to move to a program of record in fiscal year 2023. After integrating the UTAP 22 Mako drone with the Autonomy Corps, Kratos conducted its first Skyborg test flight in April. A General Atomics Avenger equipped with the Autonomy Corps took to the skies in its second Skyborg flight test in June. General Atomics, Kratos, and Boeing were tapped to build Skyborg air prototypes in December 2020. So far, Boeing's Skyborg prototype has not flown, and the Air Force plans to host its next operational exercise this fall. More drone development news out of the Middle East. Two Saudi companies have inked an agreement to co-produce and further develop the Skyguard drone for operational use. The UAV has only ever undergone testing. The deal was signed on August 19th between the Prince Sultan Defense Studies and Research Center, an advanced electronics company, which is a subsidiary of the Saudi Arabian Military Industries, better known as SAMI. The UAV, originally designed and manufactured by the Research Center, has successfully passed testing and experimentation to qualify its subsystems in different environmental conditions. Flight tests were also conducted to assess design requirements. The United States is a little closer to attaining hypersonic technology. Army and industry officials announced that the Common Hypersonic Glide Body is expected to take part in a second, more challenging flight test later this year. The Defense Department has been jointly developing the CHGB that will serve as the base of its offensive hypersonic missile. The test marks a major step forward in accomplishing that mission amid mounting criticism that the United States is behind China and Russia in hypersonic weapons development. The glide body will be made up of the weapon's warhead, guiding system, cabling, and thermal protective shield. Each service will use it as the base while developing individual weapon systems, such as launchers capable of firing weapons from the land or the sea. Hypersonic weapons are capable of flying faster than the speed of sound and can maneuver between varying altitudes and azimuths, making it harder to detect and kill. The Iron Dome system is well known for protecting Israel from rocket attacks, and it's something the United States has invested in. The U.S. Army and the Israeli Missile Defense Organization fired off the Iron Dome at White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico. The technology is made by the Israeli defense company Rafael. The U.S. Army plans to create two batteries with the system. And that's it for Defense Energy Headlines. When we return, personal finance expert Jeanette Mack explains the difference between soft and hard credit pools.